1986, and we put an album out. We got
Is that Metal Blade?
Well, it was before Metal Blade. We got signed to a little tiny indie label about 6 months after we were together called Celluloid. And then Metal Blade bought our deal from Celluloid, and then Warner bought our deal from Metal Blade.
Thank you. This was a good thing.
This was all good, you know. It's like we were sort of failing upward, and we've been with Warner Brothers for 20 years. Yeah. So
in the early days, any of you who remember early Goo Goo Dolls stuff, it's kind of more like pop punk stuff. And then I think one of the things that's great about the Goo Goo Dolls is that over the decades, you've been changing and growing and been commercially viable throughout this entire thing. I mean, and you as a songwriter, just blossoming and growing and doing stuff for film, for TV.
Thanks.
I know you're a great songwriter and a great singer. And I know, and Robbie's too.
Yes.
And I think that it's great. You know, a lot of bands don't make it this long. A lot of bands don't stay together this long. A lot of bands don't stay relevant this long. You know, I've had the same conversation with Keith Richards,
who
he doesn't know how any of it is. How any of it happened. If you have to read his book, he'll tell you about it. But I think it's cool. I think it's great. I think it's an inspiration to a lot of young bands. And here at the NAMM show, I've seen a lot of musicians and a lot of everybody's really enthusiastic, and it's really encouraging because you see people.